Hi, hello, welcome you all. All of you might have been aware about what is being going on here. I'm going to have a session on percentages for the next 1 hour. Just check with your audio and video. If you have any issues, just note down in the comment box and they will make note of it and correct it now. I hope everything is clear now. Fine pa, what are we going to see? Percentages, right? Right. First of all, you should have some basic idea about how the session is going to be, right? Percentages, something about all of you might have known about the percentages. All of you might have studied percentages in your lower classes, right? First of all, what is the purpose of percentages? We should know the basic of percentages first, and where are we using percentages? That is the next one, right? What is percentage? What is the purpose of percentage, and why are we using percentage? That should be known. Before that, we have some elements in mathematics which are we using for a purpose, that is to compare the quantities, right? In that, before going to percentages, you should know the purpose of fractions, right? The purpose of ratio, the purpose of percentages, and how we are going to link these three things. This is nothing but these three are the things that we use to compare the quantities or the numbers or whatever it is. For an example, let us take, you are the person who is securing some 60 marks in an examination, right? That is, you are securing a mark of 60 in an examination. Your friend who is securing 30 marks in the same examination, right? You understand what I'm saying? You secure 60 marks in an examination, for an example, and your friend is securing 30 marks in the same examination. When you're comparing these two marks, you can say that your friend has got half of your marks. Am I right? Got my point? Your friend has got half of your marks. That is, you will say that your friend has secured 50% of the marks that you have secured. Am I right or not? Right. That is nothing but we are comparing your friend's mark out of your marks. That is, 50% of your marks is your friend's marks. Right. This is one way, that is, we are comparing it with in terms of percentages. Second one, in terms of fraction, we can say that your friend has secured half of the marks that you have secured, right? That is nothing but like this one, your friend has secured half of the marks that you have secured. Or when we compare it in the terms of ratio, we can say that your marks, that is 60, is to your friend's mark, that is 30 marks. Is in what ratio? That is 60 to 30 is nothing but 2:1. That is nothing but you secure 2 times your friend's mark. Or if your marks is 2 parts, your friend has secured half of that. That is half of 2 is nothing but 1 part of marks. See, these are the elements that we can use in mathematics to compare the quantities, right? In that scenario, we are now going to discuss about only the percentages, right? Fine. How we are going to relate these fractions, ratio and percentages together, and how these things make sense, that we are going to see the next one, right? As I said, 1 by 2 correspondingly equal to how much percentage? 50% is nothing but this is nothing but fraction. This is in terms of percentages. Like the same, we have percentage form for the fraction 1 by 3, then 1 by 4, 1 by 5, 1 by 6, 1 by 7 and so on. Why we are deriving these things now? That is important to process the questions further in an easier way, right? First, I'll tell you the corresponding fraction forms and percentages, and then we are going to see the examples in detail, right? 1 by 2 is nothing but 50%. That is nothing but percentages is nothing but by meaning, that is per 100. Whatever the quantity, whatever the value or value, whatever being the value, when you are comparing it out of 100, you will get percentages. Percentage, right? For example, like I said, you have secured 60 marks, your friend has secured 30 marks. Out of 60, this is nothing but how much? 30. When you compare it with out of 100, you will get a percentage of marks of your friend out of your marks. Right? This is nothing but how much? This goes for 1 by 2. And 1 by 2 is nothing but how much? This will give you the percentage. 1 by 2 into 50%. 50% of your marks is your friend's mark. Hope it is clear. Now, right, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 5. Like I all said, every corresponding fraction form will have percentages, or every percentage form will have corresponding fraction form. Right? Right. Before that, what is a common, what is the general general thing that we can write the percentage in terms of? Like the value or the quantity that is compared with, let me consider why. In the previous example, we term this as your marks, 60 marks. Then it is this value, let me consider as X. This X is nothing but your friend's mark. The value or quantity that is being compared and this is the quantity or value that is compared with, right? This is the comparison in terms of fraction, like 30 by 60, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, whatever it is. When you compare it out of 100, you will get percentages, right? To find the percentage, what we will do here? Take this 100 over here, you will get what? This much. And this question mark is nothing but what is the percentage of mark or what is the percentage of quantity that X has got out of what? Out of 5. This is general statement to find percentages. Why we are putting it 100 here? Because to find the percentage, how many percentage is X out of 5, right? This is much important. This is the very basic that you should know, that Y is the value that is to be compared with your mark, 60 marks. X is number 30 marks, that is your friend's mark. The value that is being compared out of, what is the value being compared with, right? Now we come to the fraction and percentage form. 1 by 2 is nothing but how much? 50%. Out of 2, if it is 1, what is out of it? 100. 50%. Half of it, 50%. And like the same, 1 by 3. X by Y is nothing but 1 by 3 here. How will you find the percentage correspondingly here? 1 by 3 into 100. It is nothing but 33.33% approximately you will get, right? You can write it in this form also. Next one, 1 by 4. 1 by 4 is something but 25%. Right? And 1 by 5 is 20%. These 5 numbers are the basics. So 4. 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4 and 1 by 5. 50% is 33.33%. 25% and 20%. Right? see here. If you multiply this 2 with this percentage, what will you get? 2 into 50%, that is 100%. This 2 comes here to get 100%, but 2 into 50, that is 100%. What remains here? 1. It's nothing but 1 by 1 or simply 1 is something about 100%, and then 1 by 2 is 50, 1 by 3 is 3 into 33.33 will give you 100%. 4 into 25 will give you what? 100%. 1 remains in the left hand side, and here 5 into 20% will give you what? 100%. Let us see up to 1 by 6, then 1 by 7, then 1 by 8, then 1 by 9, then 1 by 10, and up to we will see 1 by 20. Right? What is 1 by 6? What is 1 by 7? What is 1 by 8? What is 1 by 9? What is 1 by 10? Correspondingly in terms of percentages. See, to have 1 by 6, that is 16.66%, that can be again derived from the value 1 by 3. Simply, what is 1 by 6 per? Half of 1 by 3, that is 1 by 6. What is 1 by 3 here percent in terms of percentage? 33.33. What is half of 33.33? It is 16.66%, simply. Right? Now, at the same time, this can be written in terms of 16.2/3%. Half of 33 is nothing but 16, half of 1 by 3. Half of 33 by 1 by 33, 1 by 3 is nothing but 16.2/3%. And 1 by 7. That is 14.28%. And this can be again written as 14.2/7%. Right? Next one is 1 by 8. Again, 7 into 14.28 will give you 100%. 16 into 16.66% will give you 100%. Like the same, 1 by 8 in terms of percentages is nothing but 12.5%. Or this can be again written as 12.1/2%. Next one. Right. One by nine, and then 1/10 up to 1/20. 1/9 is nothing but 11.11%. Right? 11.11%, or we can say that is 11.1/9% correspondingly. Next one is 1/12. That is 8.33%. How we can say, sorry, it is 1/10 before that. 1/10 and then 1/11 and then 1/12. 1/10 is nothing but 10% naturally. 10 into 10% is 100%. And then 1/11, that is 9.09%. This is equal to 9.09%, or we can write in another terms as 1/11%. This into this will give you 100%. You can check it out. Next one is 1/12. How we can say 1/12 from the previously derived percentages form? 1 by 12 is nothing but half of 1 by 6, we can say that. 1 by 6 by 2 is nothing but what? 1 by 12. Or 1 by 3 by 4, which will give you again 1 by 12. Right. It is, if you are saying that half of 1 by 6, that is nothing but, is 1 by 12 means, what is half of 16.66 power? 8.33%. Or this we can write in another terms as 1 by 3%. That is 1 by 12. Let me clear that. Then 1 by 13, 1 by 14, 1 by 15, 1 by 16, 1 by 17, and so on. Let us see 1 by 13 afterwards. Now 1 by 14. How we can derive 1 by 14 in corresponding terms of percentages? That is something but half of 1 by 7, we can say that. Like we did for 1 by 12, that is something but half of 1 by 6, and we can say that 1 by 14 is something but half of 1 by 7. We saw that 1 by 7 is something but 14.28%. Right? That is nothing but half of that is nothing but 7.14%. Or in other terms, we can say that 1 by 7%. Am I right? Next one is 1 by 15. Again, we can derive it from the previously derived percentages. There is number 1 by 5 already we have. 1 by 3 into 1 by 5. 1 by 3 times of it will give you what? 1 by 15. Then what is the value? 1 by 5 is how much pa? 20% we had seen, right? 1 by 3 times of this one will give you what? 1 by 15, that is nothing but 6.66%. Right? Or in other terms, we can say that 6.2 by 3%. That gives you what? 1 by 15. And 1 by 16. Again, we can derive this 1 by 16 from 1 by 8. What is 1 by 8? Half of 1 by 8 is about 12.5% and 1 by 16 is about half of it. 12.5, half of 12.5 is nothing but 6.25%, or in other terms we can say that 6.1 by 4% in mixed fraction percentage. Right? 1 by 17, 1 by 13. These 13 and 17 are prime numbers, and 1 by 13 is nothing but 7.69%. The things that you should mug up are the corresponding percentage for the fraction 1 by 13, 1 by 17, and like here 1 by 7, 1 by 9, 1 by 11. Why I am saying this is nothing but these are prime numbers, right? Therefore, 1 by 13 is, it has unique value, that is 7.69%. We cannot derive it from any other values here. Like that 1 by 13 is nothing but 7.69%. 1 by 17 is nothing but 5.88%, and 1 by 18, that we can derive it from what? 1 by 6 or 1 by 9. Half of 1 by 9 is nothing but how much? 1 by 18. Then what is 1 by 9 per here? First of all, 11.11%, half of it is nothing but 5.55%, or 5 by 9% in simple terms, right? Let me erase it here. Next one is All right. Next one is 1/19 and then 1/20. We saw 1/5 is nothing but how many percentage? 20%. Like the same 1/20 is nothing but 5%, which means 20 into 5 will give you what? 100%. Like the same 1/19. It is again a unique percentage form, that is nothing but 5.26% for what? 1/19. 5.26%, or we can say 5/19%. And here 7.68% or 7/9/13%. This one correspondingly, right? And then what is the other thing? 1/14 we saw it already, and 5.88% correspondingly. 1/17 is correspondingly 5.88% or 15/17%. We can say like this, we can say like this, and we can say like this. Everything is same, right? Everything is equal, right? Now you have seen different percentages and their corresponding fraction forms. From where? From 1 is corresponding equal to 100%, 1/2 is 50, and up to 1/20 we had seen. Like up to 5%, right? And how these corresponding fractional forms and percentages being derived? It's nothing but, like we said, the value which is we are comparing it with, like y, and the value is compared. Which is the value compared? X. If you multiply this with 100, you'll get the percentage value of y, which is x. There is nothing but out of 2, if it is 1, the value which is we are comparing it with, the value which is compared, out of 2 this 1 means into 100, it will give you what? 50%. Like the same 1/3 into 100, 33, 1/4, 125, and up to we had seen 1/19, 1/20. There is nothing but into 100. What is this value? 5.26%. This is how this corresponding value is being derived. Right? Fine. How we can compare the percentages, how we can compare the quantities in real terms, in real examples, right? Before going to solve the examples being provided here, let us solve an example, real time example like this one. Suppose we consider a scenario. Let us take an example. Let us consider a scenario of some four friends. Let us consider them to be A, B, C, and D, right? These four friends are going to a restaurant, or let's say Domino's. They are ordering a pizza for 1 kg, and they are distributing that 1 kg among themselves like this one. Let us say A eats 200 grams of that pizza, and B, let us say 250 grams. C eats, let us say 300 grams. How much is that? 450, 300, 750. The remaining 250 grams is eaten by, let us say, by D. Right? Fine. We can compare the quantity of food, a quantity of pizza eaten by B, C, D, A by comparing with the other person's quantity. Like for example, we can compare the quantity that has been eaten by A with compared to with respect to B, this with respect to C, or this quantity of food eaten by C with respect to A. We can compare in different terms. Let's frame some questions and we'll get clarity from that. Let us see. This is the real quantity of pizza that are being eaten by A, B, C, D, right? Suppose, let me ask you a question that how much percentage of pizza eaten by A out of total? Got my question? How much percentage of pizza eaten by A out of total? What is the total out of total quantity of pizza? 1 kg. If these are given in grams, no? This is nothing but 1 kg is 1000 grams. Fine. From this question, what is the value we are going to compare with is much important. And the second thing is about what is the quantity that you are going to compare. Okay. Whose quantity of pizza we need to compare? A's quantity of pizza. Out of what? What is the value to be compared with? Out of total. That is like x by y in the previous case. Right? What is the total pizza now here? 1000 naturally. 1 second. The value to be compared with is anybody how much? 1000. That is total quantity 1000. Whose quantity of pizza need to be compared? A. Out of 1000 grams, A ate how much? 200. If this is the case, out of 100 is how much? That is, that will give you a percentage of pizza that has A eaten out of the total pizza. Right? This how much? 20% of total pizza is eaten by whom here? A. Let us frame another more question by comparing the value of, let us say, B has eaten how much percentage of total? The value to be compared with is nothing but 1000, and value that need to be compared is B's quantity, that is nothing but how much? 250. 250 out of 1000 into how much? 100. That is nothing but how much? This goes for 4. 4 in 100 goes for 25 times, 25 percentage. Fine, let me ask you another question. Now the question, let us turn this question like this. What is the percentage of pizza that is eaten by, that is eaten more by B than E? The question is a bit twisted here. Like what? What are you going to compare with? Or what is the value that you need to that you need to compare? What is the percentage of pizza that is eaten more by B than E? You need to compare the value, the quantity of pizza that is eaten more by B than E. First of all, how many grams of pizza has been eaten by A? 200 grams, and here by B is 250 grams. Naturally, B ate 50 grams more than A. Later. Then, which is nothing but A's pizza, that is 200 grams is the value that we are going to compare it with. Out of 200, how much is the quantity of pizza that has been eaten more by B. 250 more than 200, that is nothing but out of 200 at least 50. Hold on a second. Right. Out of 200, that is the value we are comparing it with. 50 grams more than 200 is what the quantity eaten by B in extra data. This is how many percentage they are asking for this question. What is the question? Sorry, this one. 50 by 200 into 100. Isn't it naturally how much power? 25%. Something but this goes for this much, this goes for 25. See, it depends on how we are comparing the quantities with. Right? Let us say, let us compare C with B. Let me ask you a question that how many or how much percentage of pizza that is eaten more by C than B? Means what? With respect to B, C is eating how many grams more? 50 grams more. We can say like this. If this is the value, out of 100 is how much per? This goes for 5 times, this goes for 20, which is about 20%. Or we can compare it in other terms also. Like, how much percentage of the pizza that is being eaten by B less than C? Which means you need to compare the quantity with C at first. That is out of 300. Out of 300, B is eating how many grams? 50 grams less. Which means out of C's quantity, B is eating 50 grams less. In percent, in terms of percentage, is how much per? Into 100, this goes for 6. 1 by 6 into 100, that is nothing but what? 16.66% or 16.23%. Ultimately, you get the fraction that is 1 by 6, 1 by 6 correspondingly that we have derived as 16.66%, right? 16.23% like this one. This is how we can compare. We can say that 1 by 6 of the total piece of C is eaten more by B. This 1 by 6 is how much? 1 by 6 of 300. 1 by 6 of 300 will be 50. That 50 grams is eaten, sorry, less by B than C. And like we can compare with other persons also. Right, fine. These are some little basics for percentages. The next we see the questions in detail later. Fine. Fine. Let us have the first question. 5% of income A equals 15% of income B. What percentage of A is B? Right. Again, the question is like 5% of income of A equals 15% of income of B is the hint being given. What is the question? What percentage of A is B? This is the question, whereas these are the hint. 5% of income of A and 15% of income of B. Once again. What kind of quantity being compared here, Pa? Income. There are two incomes, that is A's income and B's income. 5% of A's income equals what they are saying? Percentage of B's income. Let me consider income of A as capital A, income of B as capital B. That means 5% of income of A equals 15% of B. That we can write it like this. What percentage of A is B? They are asking us to find what percentage of A's income. That is the value we need to compare it with the income of A of what? Income of B, right? Into 100. That gives you what? The value answer for this question, right? Then, since it is 5% of A equals 15% of B, can I write this percentage and percentage gets cancelled? Ultimately, what? Actually, something about 5 by 100 equals 15 by 100 of B. This 100 and 100 gets cancelled. And this goes for how many times here? 3. This is but A equals 3B. We can write it like this. And this is again being written as A by B equals 3 by 1. This is like in terms of fraction, or this can be again written as a ratio form also. A is to be something but what? 3 is to 1, which means if A's income is 3 times 3 parts and B's income will be what? 1. Now, what is the question being asked? B by A into 100. A is 3 parts, whereas B is 1. What is 1 by 3 correspondingly, Pa? 33.33%, which was already being seen. Eta. What is the answer then? 33.33%. Next question. Two numbers are 25% and 30% more than the third number. What percent is second number of the first number? Fine. First of all, how many numbers are being compared here? Three numbers. Let us consider them as A, B, and C. Such that two numbers are 25% and 30% more. Sorry. 25% and 30% more than the third number, which means they are comparing the first two numbers. Let me consider this as the first number, this as the second number, this as the third number. First and second number correspondingly are 25% and 30% more than the third number, they are saying. Which means out of C they are comparing. Let me consider C's number as, let me consider 100. When this is 100, 25% A is more than C and B is 30% more than C. That is third number. What is 25% of 100? It is 25. 25% of 100 is 25 more than C, means it is 125. And then B. If C is 100 and B is how much percentage more than C? 30% more. Out of 100 is 30% is nothing but 30. That is 30% more is nothing but 30 more than 100. That is 130. Right. Then we can term this number A as first number as 125, second number as 130, third number as 100. Right. What percent is second number of the first number? Which means we are comparing it with what percentage is the second number. What percentage is the second number out of what? The first number. What is the first number, Pa? 125. And what is the second number? This is the second number. If this is thing out of 100, it will give you what? Percentage. Right. We can strike this one with 4 times of 25. This is 5 times of 25. And here is something about how much? 2 times, that is 26. What is the value? 104%, which is nothing but second number is 104% of the first number. That is the meaning of this question, right? That is what we have derived here. Right up. What is the answer then? 104%. Clear? Next one. If A got 20% more marks more than B, What percentage did B get less than A? We are comparing 2% mark, that is A's marks and B's marks. A got 20% more, 20% marks more than B means we are comparing it out of B's marks, that A got 20% more than B's mark. We don't know the real marks of B, or we don't know the real marks of A. Let me consider marks of B as 100. Why I am considering the marks of B as 100? Because I am comparing it with B. For my convenience, let me compare it with B. To compare it with B, let me consider the marks of B as 100 marks. What is A's marks corresponding out of B? A got 20% marks more than B. If B is 100, what is 20% of 100? 20. 20 more than 100 is about how much? A would have got 120 marks. Right. Now, naturally, A's mark is more, B's mark is less when compared with A. What is the question now? What percentage did B get less than A? The marks that is being compared with is A's mark. And they are asking the question, what percentage did B get less than? How much marks is B getting less than A? 20 marks. This is what we are comparing. Out of what? Than A. A's mark is 20. Out of 120, B got 20 marks less than A. And out of 100 is how much? This will give you what? The answer. Here, this goes for how many times? 6. This 1 by 6 is correspondingly how much percentage? 16.66%. That is what? We had seen it already, right? What is the answer? 16.66%. Shall we go to the next one? Right. Two numbers are 20% and 25% less than the third number. By what percent did A get more than B? Two numbers less than third number, right? We are comparing three numbers. No real value of a number is given. Like the same two numbers are 20%. Let me consider three numbers as A, B, C. First number, second number, third number. Let me consider like this. Two numbers are 20% and 25% less than third number, right? Both two numbers, first two numbers are compared with the third number. The value which is being compared with, let me consider as 100. Let me consider the number as 100. When comparing it with 100, the first two numbers are 20% and 25% less. What is 20% of 100? 20. 20% less means, can we write it as 80 here? The next one is 25% less than the third number. Third number is 100. 25% of third number is 25% of third number is nothing but what? 25% of 100 is 25 itself. 25% less means 25 less than 100. All apart. How much? 75. Right. By what percent did A get more than B is the question. The value need to be compared with is B. What is the value need to compare? What percent did A got more than B? B's mark is 75. A got 5 marks more than B. That is the value need to be compare out of B's marks, whereas B's mark is 75. B's marks is 75. Out of 75, it is nothing but how much? 5. Into 100 gives you percentage. This goes for how many times? 15 times. And this goes for 1 by 15. What is the corresponding percentage form of 1 by 15 here? 6.2 by 3% or 6.66%. That we saw it already. Right. Fine. When 50 is added to 50% of a number, it gives the same number. This next question. What is 20% of that number? How many numbers are being compared here? A single number which is compared with a real value here. It's nothing but 50% of a number is added with how much? 50. A real number 50. It gives the same number. Which means I don't know the number. I need to find that number. And I need to find 20% of that number. right? This is nothing but let me consider that number as x. In this x, 50% of that number, that is nothing but 50% is nothing but 50 by 100 or 1 by 2. Half of that number is added with how much? 50. That is what being given here, no? This gives you what? The same number itself, which means the same number is nothing but what? X. Here, this is what the equation here that we can derive it from the given hint. And from that, we can say that x minus half x, that bring this half x over here, you will get x minus half x, that is nothing but half x is 50. And what is x? 100. If x is 100, what is the question being asked? What is 20% of that number? 20% of 100 is how much? That is the question. 20% of 100 is how much? 20, the number. Right? Fine. Or we can say, we can solve in other terms also. Try to understand. If it is being confusable, just omit it. See, what is the number need to be added to the 50% of a number? 50. Right? That is the 50% of a number. Some number need to be added to give you what? The number itself, which means 100% of the number. 50% of the number is already there. Need to add how much? 50% of the number. That gives you what? 100% of the number. This 50% of the number is nothing but 50. 50% of the number is 50 means 100% of the number is nothing but 100. 20% of the number is nothing but 20. Simple, no? Alright. Fine, let us go to the next one. If 40% of x minus y is equal to 20% of x plus y, then what percentage of x is y? Great. They are given that 40% of x plus y, sorry, x minus y equals 20% of x plus y. Here this, since these are equal, we can say, we can cancel percentage and percentage here. That is 40 times of x minus y equals 20 times of x plus y. And this goes for how many times here? 2. This is nothing but 2x minus 2y being multiplied inside here equals x plus y. From here you can say x equals, bring this x over here, 2x minus x is x, bring this minus 2y over here, we get x equals 3y or x by y. In fraction it will be like 3 by 1. This you can say at fraction, this you can say in terms of ratio, x is to y is number 3 is to 1. If x is 3 parts, y will be 1 part. Right? Right. What is the question being asked? What percentage of x is y? Which means, out of x, what is the percentage of y? This is what the question is. X by y is how much? 3 by 1. And what is y by x? 1 by 3 into 100. What is corresponding percentage form of 1 by 3 pa? That we saw it already. 1 by 3 is equal to what? 33.33%. Right? Next question. If the income of Ram is 20% less than Manoj, then income of Manoj, how much percentage more than that of Ram? We are comparing the incomes of two people, that is, one is Ram, another one is Manoj. We are comparing the income of Ram, that is 20% less than Manoj. We are comparing it with the income of Manoj. Let me consider the Manoj's income as 100 rupees. Since there is no real value is given, let me consider, let me assume the income of Manoj as 100. If income of Manoj is 100, what is the value being given? Ram's income, that is 20% less than that of Manoj, right? 20% of 100 is nothing but how much? 20. 20 less than 100 is nothing but how much? 80. What is the question now? Then income of Manoj, how much percent more than that of Ram? When compared it out of Ram's income, how much percentage is more is the Manoj's income? Out of 80, out of 80, Manoj gets 20 rupees more than Ram, which means 20 by 80, which is, what is the percentage of that? This goes for how many times? 4 times. 1 by 4. What is 1 by 4's corresponding percentage from fraction? 25%. Simple. Right. Here comes a different question than the previous ones. In a class test, A scored 10% less than B and B scored 20% more than C. If C scored 80 marks, then A's mark is how much? Right. Here we are considering 3% marks. Now we can get the help of that fractional form ratio, whatever it is later. A scored 10% less than B, which means when compared to B, A scores 10% less, which is nothing but what is corresponding fraction form of 10%? 1 by 10, which means out of every 10 parts, 1 is nothing but 10%. Right. What is this value being compared with? This value is nothing but B's. In a class test, A scored 10% less than B means, let me consider B as 10. Out of 10, A scores 1 less. What is 10 minus 1? 9. Which is nothing but out of B, if it is B's marks is 10 parts, A scores 9. Which is nothing but 1 out of 10, he scores less. That is 10%. Right. Then these two marks will be in the ratio 9 is to 10. Simple. And B scored 25% more than C. What is corresponding fraction form for 25%? We saw it as 1 by 4. Right? Whose mark is compared with whom? B scored 25% marks more than C, which means 1 by 4 is the corresponding fraction form for 25%. Means if C's mark is 4 parts, B scores 1 part more, which is nothing but 25% more. 1 part more than C's marks. This, if C is 4, what is 4 plus 1? 5. Right. Then these persons' marks will be in the ratio like this. A is to B will be 9 is to 10. B is to C will be 4 is to 5. These two should be equal, no? Because B's mark is same. Here it is 5, here it is 10. What will give, what should we do to make it equal? To make it equal, let me consider. Let me multiply this ratio with 2, where you will get 9 is to 10 for A is to B and B is to C as 2 into 5 is 10, 2 into 4 is 3, 8. So, but A is to B is to C will be like this. Right. Now, this will be the ratio of marks got by A, B and C, 9 is to 10 is to 8. Here, 9, 10, 8, 9 parts, 10 parts, 8 parts, that is about 9x or 10x or 8x. What is the mark, what is the real mark of a person? C scored how many marks? 80 marks upper. So, but this is the marks being given. This is equal to 80 marks. 8x equals 80 means x will be how much? 10. Now, what is the question being asked? A's mark. What is A? 9 times of x, it is 9 times of 10. How much is that? 90. Right? Here comes another type of question, that is, in a library, 30% of staff are females. In that, 20% of females voted for me and 50% of males voted for me. How much percentage of total votes did I get? Fine. There is no real number of votes being given here, right? Let me consider, there are 100 votes in total. Why I am assuming it as 100? Because it is easy to get percentage of that, right? 100 is the total votes in that in a library 30% of staff, this 100 works is about 100 people. Out of this 100, 30% of staff are female. It means 30% of 100, 30% of 100 is number 30. 30% are female. Next one. Sorry, 20% of female. Sorry. 30% only. Sorry. 30% of 100 is number 30. That those are female. The remaining will be males. That is nothing but what? 100 minus 30 will be 70. 70 people will be male. In that, 20% of females voted for me. What are the number of people voted for? The person, me. 20% of 30 voted for me, and 50% of males. 50% of males voted for me. This is what they have given, no? What is 20% of 30, pa? That is, out of 100 is 20. Out of 30 we should find, no? That is 30. This goes for how much? 6. Out of 100 people, 30 are females. Out of 30 females, 6 females voted for me. Right. Next here. Males. In terms of males, 50% of males voted for me. What is 50% of 70? That is 50 is nothing but half. Half of 70 is how much? 35. Males voted for me. What is the question? How much percentage of total votes did I get? I got 35 males vote and 6 females vote. On total, how much? 41 votes I got. Out of what? Out of what is the total votes we consider? We assumed 100. Out of 100 is how much? This much percentage of votes I got. Right? Fine, let us have the next question. The difference between 70% of a number and 50% of the same number is 400. Then 50% of that number is how much? Simple. The difference between 70% of a number, we don't know the number, that is, let me consider as x. 70% of a number, that is nothing but 70 by 100 of x, or simply 70% of x. And 50% of the same number, is means nothing but x. 50% of the same number, that is nothing but like this, gives you what? 400. 70% of the same number minus 50% of the same number will get 20% of. If you take x as common, 70% minus 50% will be what? 20% of x. This 20% of x is how much? 400. That is 20 by 100 of x equals 400. Then what is x? This 5 goes here, you will get 5 times of 400 is 2000. What is the question being asked? The number is not being asked, but the 50% of the number is being asked. What is 50% of 2000? Half of 2000. What is half of 2000? 1000. Right. Tell me time and how many go? 15. 15. Time acha? 15 minutes. Right. Fine. Let us move to the next type of question, that is type 2. Based on marks in the examinations, right? Now, up to now, we have compared the marks, the income of different persons, and we found what is the percentage of this person's income out of that person's income, or how much percentage more this person has got more than B or more than other person, like that we had seen. Now, the question type is, this is based on the marks in the examination. Let's see the question first. Right. What's the question, pa? In the CAT exam, Ram got 10% more than Sheila. Sheila got 50 marks, like the same. we had seen it earlier. Whose marks being compared here? Two persons' marks have been compared here. One is Ram, another person is Sheila. In the CAT exam, Ram got 10% more than Sheila. Whose mark has been compared with? Sheila's mark is compared with what? Ram's mark need to be compared with the Sheila's mark, right? When comparing it with Sheila, Ram got 10% more. That means let me consider Sheila's marks to be 100. Then how much percentage of marks might have got by Ram here? One second. Sorry guys, hold on for a minute. It seems to be some issues. Sorry for one thing guys, there seems some issues with the video. It cannot be seen by you now, so let us finish it off now. Let us wrap up this session now. We'll see the rest of the percentages in the next class, which means by tomorrow by the same time, right? We'll see the rest of every possible types of questions by next class, which means by tomorrow. Right, fine. go through the things, basic elements that we have seen today. Go through that, have some basic understanding. Just practice these questions, practice this basic stuff of percentages, and then by tomorrow we'll see the rest of things and we'll have some recap of what we have seen today. Take a recap tomorrow. Right, fine. See you tomorrow. Have a nice sleep. Good night.